Right, same setup as last time. We've got the thermistor here, beaker, empty beaker, thermistor connected to a multimeter set to measure resistance. We've got the range quite high, that's on 20 kilo-ohms. I'm going to leave it on that because obviously the resistance is going to drop as the temperature goes up. We've got Chromebook this time, running the SparkView software, so that's going to be connected wirelessly to the Pasco wireless temperature sensor. Okay, so if I pop that in there like that, so that's going to be sat as close to the thermistor as possible. Okay, all we need now is boiling water, which I'll get from the kettle. Right, so if we start recording the temperature, so that's the temperature at the moment, and in goes the boiling water. So as we can see, the temperature jumps right up. So the temperature of that water from the kettle looks like it was 94 degrees Celsius. So already the temperature is dropping, but we need to wait for the resistance of the thermistor to drop to the lowest point. It's because of the thermal inertia of the thermistor. The actual semiconductor slice in the thermistor, that's the thing that measures the resistance. That's the thing that's going to be measuring the temperature. That's obviously encased in glass. So glass, not the best conductor of heat. So it just take a while for the semiconductor slice to become the same temperature as the surrounding water. Okay. So we're almost there. I think this, I remember from the last video, I think this was our starting point, 0.57 kilo-ohms or 0.56 kilo-ohms. So, as soon as that starts to go up, because the temperature is dropping slowly but consistently, I think this could well be our starting point.